here, or are they just holding their position? Still doesn't top me off. An explodey thing.
If you require help carrying any items, I will assist.
Do I need help right now? Yes, I do. Oops.
Captain, we should continue. Carrying objects is one of my...
Yeah. Equinox. Combat tech. You got my resources. Using up a lot of weight. Yeah, it is. Vasco can't carry anymore. Okay. See anybody? I'm gonna drop that. I don't need another hazmat suit. I don't even know if I need one hazmat suit. All of a twist again. Shadows in the attic. Oh, there's someone up there. Oops. Whoa, he goes. Someone just threw something from up there. We're not claiming ownership here. Oops. Does not feel pain, but it's terrible. This is what I'm using? This little thing? Let's try the Equinox.
I hear it. Terrible.
Where is he? Up top? Oh, cool. Is that it? Did you kill the last one? That was very nice of you. Safety protocol. Remember to follow all decontamination procedures before exiting this area. Alright. Scan them. Instant oatmeal. And that's a lot of credits, 691. I think that's the most we found. Oh, that's locked. Awesome. More genetic sample bottles. Because I don't know what the sound he makes or like, what are you actually doing? I might end up dropping these... Ooh, fragmentation mines? I might end up dropping these genetic sample bottles, but they look like they have a good value for their weight, which is why I'm picking them up. Ah, not another safe. Wait. Because I did it with scan. Alright, let me just get my health back here. A bunch of worms and water. Yeah, that's not gonna do it. I'm really just eating this stuff to lower my weight and get my health up. I know it's incredibly unrealistic. Okay. Good enough. I'm gonna leave my health as is. No digipicks! Damn it. Survival killing or survival response? Consult Mendelheim. Reminder, survival. Well, if I find a digipick in one of these, I know what to do. Nope. Oh, there's another computer. Now, what is that? Oh, the crit stick. 197. I will try to remember to come back here if I get a crit stick and unlock that. Chemists have all the solutions. Haha, get it. Sarcasm. I love it. Unpredictable. Synaptic response quotient unpredictable. Sounds like a problem. Alright, saving just in case this crashes again. Hayden Winn's project terminal. War. Okay. This January 5th. The other ones were 2306. Did I miss the computer back there too? January 5th, 2308. And now he's senior xenobiologist at Crete Research Facility. We're at war. By establishing the colony of Vesta, the Freestar Collective have forced the UC's hand. The unmitigated gall, thinking they could establish control over a fourth star system. I just automatically think of the Grinch movie with Jim Carrey. Unmitigated gall. Such a flagrant violation of the Treaty of Narion. Our diplomats tried to resolve this peacefully, but the Council of Governors wouldn't listen to reason. Apparently, they claimed that Vesta was not a colony, but rather just an insignificant farming outpost. Nice try. By all accounts, the Red Devils and Stalkers worked in perfect unison, and the results were everything we could have hoped for. No Red Devil or Stalker casualties. Vesta's defenders were apparently taken by complete surprise, which greatly contributed to their fatality rate, 93%. This is a great day for the Red Devils, a great day for the United Colonies, and a great day for Xeno warfare. Nope. Note. No, it's not lost on me that this classified facility is actually located within Freestar Collective space. So goes the great game. Huh. Phase 2. April 5th now. Yeah, quite a few months. It's finally time. After a number of successful missions with the Red Devils, the Stalkers have proven to be exactly the weapons we had hoped for. So it's time to expand our operations. MAST has finally approved the next stage of this facility's operations. Project Petshop. Phase 2 will now commence. Okay. We crash sometimes with computer terminals. Let's try again. Right, we'll now commence. April 18th, 2308. We've officially stopped work on the Stalkers. There are enough creatures in the field to serve the Red Devils, who haven't been here to train in over a year. If they need more, we can easily gather some from the planet and fit them with NCIs. But from this point on, our focus is Phase 2. Heat leeches. We found one of those back in the beginning. May 1st. Throughout the settled systems, from civilized worlds to backwater bush towns, pilots have had to deal with the nuisance known commonly as the heat leech. I had my own unpleasant experience 4 years ago at the New Atlantis spaceport. My transport was delayed while the deck crew removed a few of these filthy little things from the aft thrusters. They're attracted to heat, feed off of it through some endothermic process, so thrusters are the perfect place for them to hide. They can take a full afterburner burst with no ill effects. No ill effects on the heat leeches, that is. A ship with an infestation can generally expect a 3 to 5% drop in thruster efficiency. That's something I need to worry about. Working with the heat leeches has been interesting, if not entirely satisfying. We have 11 of them in the lab, and by all accounts they are completely innocuous, save for their heat siphoning properties. But what if there were a way to weaponize them? Perhaps artificially enhance their heat siphoning to completely and instantly disable a ship, or even better, to somehow reverse the process so that they transfer their own heat into a ship. Someday. Today, I fear we lack the means to do either. Okay. Shadows in the attic, I didn't look at. In 2297, then unknown author Paul Lamont published the horror novel Shadows in the Attic. It quickly went on to become one of the highest grossing books in the settled systems. Martin, standing on the front lawn, peered up at the small attic window. What do you see, Marty? Do you see the little girl? The ghost everyone is so afraid of? Eva asked, almost laughing at the absurdity of the local legend. No, not a ghost, Martin responded. Only shadows. Okay. Does it get better? Since I had a feeling out here there was a computer. Well, I don't even know what this is. Let me just look out here really quick. I just have a feeling I Did I look at this one? I think I might not have looked at this one. Of course, I'm saving. Do you mind? Project Petshop, okay. I remember that. February 11th, 2307. Okay, so this is continuing from the other, the first computer. This is in between the one we just looked at and the first one. My staff and I just arrived this morning, and I'm not surprised to find the facility completely operational. As usual, the United Colonies spared no expense. It's all very exciting. Inspirational, really, knowing you have the full support of the decision-makers. I have to admit, I was surprised to learn that the lab is a closely guarded secret located in Freestar Collective space, no less. But we go where the work takes us. Xenowarfare is the evolution of armed ground conflict. We know it, and the Freestar Collective surely knows it as well. Forget what the calendar says, this is 1942 all over again. We may as well be the Manhattan Project, racing to create the game changer before the other side. So to that effect, I am overjoyed to officially announce Project Petshop Phase 1 is a go. No, it's Phase 2 is the one now. Arthropods. March 3rd, 2307. The arthropods are, in a word, incredible. Calm, easy to work with, and they even allow themselves to be fitted with the NCIs without much trouble. Synchronization has, thus far, been nearly instantaneous, and their control fidelity has remained in the 95 to 97% range. They've passed all environmental survivability tests as well. Hot, cold, low, or no oxygen, I'm pretty sure these things could operate effectively in any environment. Most promising is how well they've already integrated with the Red Devils, who have joined us for a period of extended training. After all, they'll be leading the creatures in the combat, so it's critical they establish a war bond. A war bond? Success! August 7th. After months of testing a variety of extraterrestrial species, I am overjoyed to report that we have finally found a species that will serve as the backbone of the United Colonies Xenowarfare Division. The arthropods are everything we hope for and more. Imagine a pack of alien beasts suited to any terrain, capable of instantly obeying any command. I have designated these beasts Obedientes Pes, but we just call them stalkers. Yeah, it's easier. I think it may finally be time to crack open that bottle of Chateau Evignon 2170. And finally, the Red Devils. August 12th. The Red Devils' progress with the Stalkers has been nothing less than amazing. Now I see why they're so highly regarded in UC military circles. None of the rah-rah bullshit you see with the regular grunts. These are focused professionals. After another week of training here in the pet shop, I'm confident they'll be ready for a live test in the field. Suggests I contact Colonel Kasarov and find out where his Marines grabbed that spider from the early trials. He wants his comeuppance, but then it would make for a good trial. Okay, good. We may now continue. Alright, this contained nothing at all. Gray elbow grease gear. Credits and chlorine. So I looted him already. Back driver. What's my way at? Oh. Okay. Picking up Vasco, even though he's behind me. I thought his arm twirling like that was someone running back there. Alright. This is where I went in. This is a dead end, right? Yeah. This has the, an injector and lead. What is that thing? Oh, the pirate. Pirate survival pack. Didn't help him survive now, did it? I guess that's me breathing every once in a while. I thought it was somebody else. Sell all those things. Toast! A slice of toasted white bread, best enjoyed when burned, buttered. Buttered or jellied, but it can be eaten as is in a pinch. The knife is stuck in it, that's cool. Yeah, that's what my brother loved, his toast burned for some reason. Well, still does. Used to, I don't know if he still does actually. Good question. Alright. Research 02. That can be opened. And lab 1. Kidney dish. Is it just a dish in the shape of a kidney? No direct path. Are these openable things? I guess not. That's pretty good value. Toxin. Pardon me. Checking for any other doors or anything. Is there a way to... save real quick. Is there a map? Map is D. Show me. I don't mind. I wanted a map of the facility. So I assume, yeah, we go up there to talk to him. credits. And a digipick! Yay! Pardon me. Toxin. I'm gonna have to go try to open that safe now. Spice wormies. Serve no worm before their turn. Now, where was that safe? Back here, wasn't it? Me. It was back more before this room. Oh, beer. I missed that too. Wasn't I in here? Oh, why? I wasn't here. Okay. That's not gonna work. Undo R doesn't work. I need a pick that only has one thing. I have zero undos. Aw, man. You gotta choose which one. Yeah, I'm getting the hang of it, guys. I'm getting the hang of it. I wasted it. I was so excited, too. Maybe I'll find another. Remember, it's in this little side passage. You gotta punish me even more. Alright, so I guess I'm done down here. I'm gonna go up the stairs. I suppose so. Yeah, I know they're dropping stuff because he can't carry anymore. Red Harvest lentils and Red Harvest naan. So the notebooks are like this game's version of ruined books in Skyrim. There's all these books around that you cannot read. Very frustrating. A plunger. Oh, there's Hayden! Empty coffee bag. I found Hayden. Two digipacks. Milk and argon. We're gonna try again. Oh, we got another computer terminal unfolding. It's another thing that makes icky sounds. Deep mining space helmet. I don't know if I can even take that. I didn't even realize it was unlocked. Okay, so I've got two. Well, it wants four. You better off using like the most amount available. If it fits. If this one won't fit at all. That's not gonna do it. You kidding me? Someday I'll get the hang of this. I can undo one. I guess if you advance in the skill, you get more redos. Okay, so that doesn't fit that. It fits that. And it fits that. And that. Skill or something? Well, I'm further along in the progress. Okay. Awesome. Yeah, I'm not taking this deep space helmet. Dr. Winn emergency slate. That was a cred stick on the other thing that I couldn't pick up. That's not fair. Dr. Winn emergency slate. Let me just look at everything else first. Yeah, that's it, really.
Tried to sync with the neural control interface, it just completely flipped out. Broke through its containment chamber like it was made out of paper. It killed Michelson, Cobb, and Sumatri in all of 1 minute.
It is Michelson.
I'm not even sure where it is now. It took off deeper into the facility. A security detail went in after it, but good friggin' luck. When I know it's safe, I'm going to make a run for the comm relay. Try to call in the cavalry. This is Hayden Winn, lead xenobiologist. Wishing he had gone to dentist school like his parents wanted.
Huh. Dentist school. Well, and then we got the computer. And that's it. This room. I put the I in T. Alright, so... what's up there? Oh, it's just notebooks. I really wish I could pick that up, that helmet. But I know, as it is, I'm not going to be able to carry the stuff I want and the additional things I'm going to find. So I'm going to save because... crashing? Terramorph specimen. Terramorph. August. Now the other thing that was spoken aloud is no date. But this is August 15, 2310 now, next year. Thanks to the UC Marines, we now have the second piece of the puzzle, a fully grown alpha predator. According to my research, a group of astrogeologists made first contact nearly 100 years ago on some remote moon. The creature didn't appear to be indigenous and was alone. There's currently no record of how it got there. So it was sheer cosmic chance that the astrogeologists found it, or rather, it found them. Scientists were quick to categorize it Occisio Machina, roughly killing machine. The UC Marines tasked with taking it down chose a simpler name, Terramorph. I read the official record once. Of the 8-person squad, only 2 of the grunts survived, and 1 of those 2 lost a leg. Such an exciting time to be in Xeno warfare. I don't think the grunts agree. NCI fitting today, August 20th. Today we fit the Terramorph with the NCI. If our experience when the grunts first dropped off the creature is any indication, our sedation window will be around 15 minutes. We'd better make them count. Storage. Well, we're getting close to him, I think. Rotational door. We'll be continuing this next episode. I had no idea it would take this long to go through this facility. Most of the reason it's taking me this long is all the items and then reading all these logs and books out loud. It takes a while. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.